Hey yo together and very welcome to another episode of the StarCraft 2 Crazy Replay. Today on Acid Planet with another TVZ, as we have in the top left hand side spawning in red, it is the Sir Rientis. And in the bottom right hand side in blue, it's me, the Terra and Alex Usher. Whoopsie. Okay, so I don't know why exactly this TVZ now is said to be awesome, but apparently it is. So we will see what's going on here very soon. I have to say TVC currently is really difficult, and this is one of the older replays where, as you can see, I'm not playing the 60 marine drop but something else, probably something with Raven, but we will see. I don't really know. But I know it's a build I played quite a long time, and I am against the hedge first, so that is also totally fine. Yeah, I am recording. Okay, good. Nice. Very nice. So there comes the spawning pool, and here we have the barracks going up. Pretty standard stuff. I could also play Hellions, but I'm not going to do that. I don't like it. And in Heart of the Swarm, the Hellions were really powerful. They were, because of the timing when they arrived on the map, they were somewhat decent against queens, because there were not, I guess, four queens out already when the Hellions popped out, but just a few with some circlings or roaches, then you need to pull back, but you had more options. Now I feel like if you go to play Hellions, it doesn't work that well any longer. So that's really unfortunate. So there's the Reaper. Oh, look at that. Ah, there comes the barracks. Okay, interesting. I didn't think I would do this. Huh. Okay, so then it definitely is the 60 marine drop, as you can see. Very interesting. So where's the gas? I need to take the gas here. There we go. So speed is halfway done. Hatchery comes down, that's fine. I have one replay I want to show you, and I just want to show it to you because of one move which should be played in GSL way more often, because it's super cool and it was so clutch when I pulled it off. It was in Archon mode. When I pulled it off, I felt like a GSL champion. I know it's a little bit weird to say that, but it felt so amazing to pull that one off, because it was a pretty smart, clutch and game winning move. Without that, we would have lost super easily. But you will see it when it comes. I guess I will record it today. At least I hope I get to record it today. Can I really kill that overlord? Oh wow! I actually can. Oh, no hold command there. And he loses it. And he loses another one. That's annoying. That should never happen, losing two overlords, because now he needs to spend lava on overlords instead of drones or circlings or anything else. So that definitely hurts. And I'm actually going for the 60 marine drop. Didn't think that would happen, but apparently that's the case. Very interesting. And I still have the Reaper to scout around. That's nice. But I didn't scout a lot, so meh, that's bad. Yeah, that is so bad. Oh! What I probably should have done is have the Reaper here. to distract from the drop which is coming. And because I okay, I just went over the circling, which is bad. Meh. But maybe I could have lured him away. So let's see how much damage I can deal. And he's supply capped again a little bit here. There are marines, 50 marines instead of 16, not perfectly done. No scan available as it looks like. I go in and there we go. Pew, pew, pew. What do I get here? Oh, I get the queen. I get two more queens. And the fourth one. And an overlord. That could be game ending already. So much damage dealt here. Another stim. Chasing the drones. Not sure if smart or not, but you need to do something. Now my units are split up a little bit here, but certainly it's not enough to kill them. They are super low, need to be healed up again. Stim again? Okay. I hope my macro is solid, but that looks like I need to pull back here. And he survives. However, he lost a lot in this game so far. That medivac needs urgent repair. There's another drop coming up. I produce a Viking for some reason, but there are no overlords to snipe for me, so that's unfortunate. I need to pick up here immediately. Pick up, pick up, pick up! No, I picked up too late. That's bad. So he's going up into lair. Wailing Nest. 1-1 on the way. Yep. Spore Crawler here. He still sees that. I need to kill that Zergling. And as you can see, my macro not rock solid. It's really bad. All those barracks should have add-ons right now. Completed, to mention. Which is not the case. I go in again. Stim, kill a creep tumor, pull back. Not losing that much. So that's fine. He needed to remake Queens. But he's looking okay, I would say. So there we go again. He finds it. Will I pull up again? This time... No, I'm losing again. All marines. That's bad. I should keep more track of my drops. Also, if I pull back. It's just important. And it looks like he sticks to Lingbane for a long time now. Still no Hydralisk then or Spire on the way. So that's interesting. He gets the fourth base finally, which he definitely needs. But he has nothing to kill the medivacs, and you need something against the medivacs. That is really important. However, that Bioforce has almost more Widowmines than Marines, so it's not really strong or dangerous. But with the addition of the other 6 barracks, this could change very soon. We are pretty damn even in supply. Widowmine spread looks somewhat decent. I go in, kill 1-2 creep tumors, maybe I can kill 2 more. His army, if you want to call it like that. Way out of position, he doesn't have much. Ah, there we go. But no speed so far. Which is unfortunate for him, and he doesn't see it, you see. Creep is not granting vision. Creep tumors are. Yeah, the Viking still on the hunt, doesn't get anything done here. Very idle, I could have attacked a little bit earlier here, go in. Try to deal damage, 1-1 still far away, I should be halfway done with 2-2 now. There we go. And I just need to pull back, I can't do much here. But now I know where his army is, potentially can go further. Reinforce a little bit, Viking still on the hunt, not doing much here. There we go, scan, creep 1 tumor. 2 tumor, 3 tumor, a 4th one as well. Maybe I can get a Hydralisk. No, I can't, and I need to boost away. And I try to lure him in. Don't quite get it. Ooh, traitor mine. Okay, I see. There are the queens trying to get the creep done, and they probably can. Zerglings, Banelings rolling in again. Very good spread here, so the Widowmine's not dealing too much damage. However, the kiting back off creep seems solid. Still taking a lot of damage, but the Hydralisks don't have any cover now. The creep tumors, however, get planted and looking quite okay, forcing me to scan again. It still hangs in there somewhat. I do have the upgrades for my Marauders, so they slow down units when they hit them. There's another attack coming in. Maybe I want to scan, maybe not, I don't know. And it looks like I finally want to get this hatchery. Not quite sure if I can get it, however, I can attack here, potentially get it. Need to pull back, but he might kill some of those medivacs where I attack here. I should go for the drones, not sure what this is doing here, that's so wasted. There are idle medivacs in the midst of his base there, and He still kills more and more medivacs. That's so wasted. Oh my god. I still get the hatchery. I don't know how or why. I come back in here losing a lot in the process. Yeah, I'm not sure if that was worth it or not. Behind that, we both have massive over minute bank, so that's bad. I still have no transition into 3-3. It's just now starting 2-2, which is super bad. So no wonder he can hang in there. 2-2 against 1-1, and he probably will just win this if he continues to trade like he does. He definitely turned the game back to be even. He needs still to create some creep tumors, but this attack probably, especially now, can deal some damage. We will see. Or maybe it goes into some weird base trade. There's another command center, and the good thing is I will scout this now with the SCV. Will I react in time? I get that command center will die. No cancel, immediately lift off. That didn't really much, but 400 minerals down the hill. They are dead. Minerals I never will see again. And the turrets. I needed those. And he goes in for attack number 2 while I'm dropping heavily here. I think I can kill his main base. The mainling is wasted on the marauder. It's not what you want to do. He pulls back. But there's nothing to defend. A lot of units I got here. But they are not focusing anything. I get a gas geyser, which is nice. But not what I really need. And now another attack on the circling's not doing much. I should attack now. While he retreats, I should attack this base, that base, that base. However, every base. Which I'm not doing. It looks like I can maybe get the lair. That would be nice. 2-2 still far away. Only halfway done. And I'm not focusing anything here. I guess the drop dealt some damage. Oh, I can pull back here. So that's nice. But I didn't get the lair. I killed some drones. But that's it. And he still hangs in there. There comes my attack. But without any medivacs. That's really bad. How many medivacs do I have left? 3. Very bad macro. I want to have 8 to 12, please. That's the interesting part here. I am 50 supply ahead, but he still hangs in there. And potentially he can still do this. He has a lot of gas in his bank. Not sure what those marauder are trying to do here. Maybe kill another base if they can. Oh, don't waste the banings on all the marauder! Don't do that! Okay, he's smart enough to not do this, but attacking there with banings not really worth it at all. Another base gets taken out. Here's a small group of... Oh, the banelings! Into the marauder. He can't clear it, but it is expensive. And he's behind in a lot of terms, even on upgrades now. His injects are looking quite solid. There's a queen missing. I guess it got killed. He has a macro hedge. He still can somewhat survive this onslaught over and over again. Probably his army is not too weak. Those Hydroliths are strong, they have not every upgrade, which is unfortunate for him. He definitely wants the range upgrade. Ah, good Widowmine shot there. Killed some of the Circlings. Racing those Marauders, not worth it at all. And now he has momentum, and that's the big issue. Momentum is super strong. And if he pulls in here and really does a lot of damage, this gets really awkward suddenly. I don't have much army left. As you can see, he somewhat cleared this army I got. And I am in a lot of trouble here. This momentum push is really strong. Need to pull the SCVs here for a short duration of time. I think I still can't win with the units I got here. The Widowmine is not too bad. Might get a nice connection here. It looks like I barely can hang in. Yeah, pulling to the planetary is important, however. I managed to survive, but not without some losses. And... More and more units come across the map. He has the drones, not the perfect saturation, but it looks like it is enough for now to bash his head over and over into my forces. Which is happening right here. And my income is not looking too good. And that's a big attack. All those banings, they could crush a base, they could kill all the SCVs if they want to do so. I don't know where those SCVs are moving. That's not a lot of SCVs. Just wasted there. It looks like I wanted to take a base and completely failed in doing so. Yeah, there are all the banings crushing into the planetary, but Does he get it? Ah, he kills a lot of stuff, but doesn't get the planetary and not too many kills here. That wasn't too well executed. He now evened out the worker count a little bit, but lost a lot of paintings in the process, and if he can attack, if he can call the other attack, I don't know. I have to say, when I played this game, it was way more stressful than it looks like here. But I think I slowly but surely can win here and close it out for me, if I do this correct. More and more reinforcements from the hatcheries are moving in, but it looks like those Marauders are just a little bit too beefy, can't get killed here, and there's another attack here at the fourth base, which will probably kill the base as well. He can't clear it, he loses on both fronts, and I would say that should be GG any second or minute now, because there's not much he can do. If he can't mine, and this base is almost mined out, there we go, GG will play it. And that's it. Thank you so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed. As always, I wish you a very nice day and goodbye. Hey, oh there, thank you for watching. If you'd like to support me, simply hit the thumbs up button. Do you have any wishes, feedback or suggestions? Put them into the comments below. You may also subscribe if you're new to the channel. I wish you a wonderful and stress-free day. Take care. Bye-bye.